Hello everyone, my name is David Xiao. I'm a partner engineer at Google Cloud. Joining me today is Mason Yan, a senior partner solution engineer from Wiz. Today, we're here to talk with you about how to leverage Google SecOps, Wiz, and Gemini together to simplify and accelerate your security operations in Google Cloud. We will start by setting up the integration to ingest Wiz findings into Google SecOps. Then get Wiz MCP server deployed from the marketplace to Cloud Run. Then we'll install the SecOps MCP server. And last but not least, we'll use Gemini CLI as the agent to interact with the MCP servers. It's very exciting, so let's get started. With that, I will hand it over to Mason for the integration setup.
Thanks, David. The Wiz and SecOps integration sends Wiz issues and detections to Google SecOps. Setup is simple. Get your SecOps customer ID and collection agent ingestion authentication file that will be used as the service account key when you create integration at Wiz tenant. Once you have the integration created, config the automation rule to send Wiz issues and detections to Google SecOps.
Now let's move on to deploying Wiz MCP in GCP. We can pull the image and then use Docker CLI to push it to the artifact repository. Now that the image is in the artifact repository, we will go ahead and deploy it in Cloud Run. Select the image from the repository. Noting the Wiz credential is stored as secrets for security, let's go ahead and deploy it as a service. It's worth noting that Cloud Run service by default requires IAM authentication for security. So in the local console, we will use gcloud CLI to authenticate and connect to the remote Wiz MCP server. This will expose a local proxy for the agent client to connect to. Now let's install the SecOps MCP server in the local environment. You can find all the setup instructions on GitHub, and it's fairly straightforward to follow. With both MCP servers installed, we need to configure Gemini CLI. When a CLI configuration is done, we need to get application default credential for the SecOps MCP server. Now it's time to launch Gemini CLI, and with that, I will hand it over to Mason.
Thanks, David. I will start our demo right here in the Gemini CLI. For this scenario, I'll be playing the role of SecOps analyst. My first priority is to check for any worrisome threats in my Google Cloud environment. Before we start, I'd like to show you the available MCP tools. Type /MCP to see the MCP tools in Wiz and SecOps. I'll simply ask Gemini, search for any critical events in the last hour. In the background, Gemini translates my request and sends it to Google Cloud SecOps MCP server. This server has access to all the security data that SecOps has been ingesting and enriching. And just like that, we have our answer. SecOps has found two critical events, a DNS query for a known crypto mining domain, and malware execution. This obviously urgent. Let's dig into malware execution. I will continue my investigation right here in Gemini. I ask Gemini more details on malware execution. SecOps quickly provides a threat name specific malware detected. It tells me the infected resource was a container and actor was a service account. I need to know how this incident started. We use Wiz Defend for threat detection, investigation, and response in my Google Cloud environment. I want to ask Wiz how this incident started. This is where the integration truly shines. As an analyst, I don't have to stop logging to different console and manually search for the threat in Wiz, because we have already configured the Wiz MCP server. Gemini can now query Wiz investigation graph for deeper context. I just keep asking questions. I ask Gemini, Wiz get thread with the thread name from SecOps. Gemini returns with more detail on the malware and the locations. I need to help Gemini focus on the thread. I ask Gemini, get detail of the critical thread in the last hour. Now Gemini responds with a level of the details that SecOps alone won't have. It showed the key detections that make up this single thread. I want to see all the detections. I ask Gemini, show me the detections in the thread. Wiz returned with 5 detections for the thread. I need to know the completed attack timeline. I ask Gemini, show me the timeline of the events. Wiz generates a completed attack timeline. A privileged container was created, which was immediately followed by a root user starting an interactive session. We see the Kubernetes service account token was accessed. A network scanning tool was executed. From there, they download XMRig crypto miner and set up an outbound connection to start mining. In just a few seconds, I have the full context, timeline, the scope of this thread. So let's recap what we just saw. We went from a high-level alert in Google SecOps to deep root cause analysis that uses information from a Wiz investigation graph. We use one single interface, the Gemini CRI, to trace the entire attack from the initial malware alert all the way back to the creation of a privileged container. This is a powerful example of what is possible when you integrate two best-in-class products. By combining Google SecOps and the Wiz Defend, the security team can understand, investigate, and act on cloud threats faster than ever before. David, back to you to close us out.
Thanks, Mason. We are very excited about what Google Cloud and Wiz can do together for our joint customers. Thanks for watching.